Yes, sir. So we should start now.
Yeah.
I'll allow the screen sharing. And so I'll welcome everyone and then we'll start.
Yeah.
Good evening, everyone. मैं दीपेश कपूर Max Healthcare की तरफ से आप सभी का स्वागत करता हूँ. आज जैसा कि आप सब जानते हैं वर्ल्ड सुसाइड प्रिवेंशन डे है और आज हमारे साथ हैं डॉक्टर मधुसूदन सोलंकी जो सीनियर कंसल्टेंट हैं साइकेट्री मैक्स स्मार्ट हॉस्पिटल साकेत में. आज हम सर से ये जानेंगे कि कैसे हम ये पता लगा सकते हैं कि कौन सुसाइड की तरफ बढ़ रहा है और उसको कैसे हम लोग हेल्प कर सकते हैं. डॉक्टर मधुसूदन को बहुत सालों का अनुभव है साइकेट्री में और इस तरह के केस डील करने में. वो एडल्ट्स इन जेरेटिक मेंटल हेल्थ साइकोथेरेपी पेशेंट एम्पावरमेंट में काफी काम कर चुके हैं और वो उन्हें कई अवार्ड्स भी मिले हैं, कई रिसर्च पेपर वो पब्लिश कर चुके हैं. डॉक्टर सोलंकी, मैं आपसे रिक्वेस्ट करूंगा कि आप हमारे इस ऑडियंस को संबोधित करें.
राइट. थैंक यू सो मच दीपेश, थैंक यू फॉर द काइंड वर्ड्स एंड इंट्रोडक्शन. So today we are all here to discuss a very unfortunate, grossly misunderstood and stigmatized subject of suicide. Basically, suicide comes from a Latin word. The word suicide comes from Latin word sui, meaning oneself, and sedium, meaning a killing. So it basically means killing oneself. Khud ko maar dena, atmahatya kar lena. Now, the history of suicide is as old as the history of human civilization. It has been variously glamorized, romanticized, hated, condemned, bemoaned at various times. But every suicide leaves more questions than answers. Such a complicated subject it is. Ek bahut hi jatil vishay hai ye suicide. इसलिए इसके बारे में समझना, इसको जानना सुइसाइड प्रिवेंशन का एक अहम हिस्सा है. तो अगर आप इस वर्ड को देखें, इट ग्रैब्स योर अटेंशन, राइट? दिस वर्ड ग्रैब्स एवरीवन्स अटेंशन. द अनफॉर्चुनेट पार्ट इज दैट द स्टेप्स दैट लीड टू सुइसाइड, वेरियस साइंस दैट लीड टू सुइसाइड are often ignored. And that's why we are here discussing today as a part of suicide prevention. How can one recognize the warning signs of suicide? What are the risk factors for suicide? And what one can do as an individual and as a collective, as a society, on government level, on organizational level, what we can do to prevent suicides. So suicide, usually people think suicide is about dying. कोई मरना चाहता है इसलिए suicide कर लेता है. Suicide is not about wanting to die, but it is about not wanting to live. It is about escaping the unbearable pain somebody is going through. It is a means to try and end a situation in which a person is feeling trapped. ये मरने के बारे में नहीं है, ये ना जिंदा रहने के बारे में है. ये समझना भी बहुत important है. Why are we talking about it? Why understanding suicide, knowing about it and preventing it is important? Because you will be surprised to know, har saal duniya mein 8 lakh log suicide se mar jate hain. More than 8 lakh people. It will almost reach a million. There is under reporting also. Maybe it is a million right now as well. Every 40 second a person is dying through suicide. And for each suicide, there are more than 20 suicide attempts. 20 suicide attempts for one successful suicide. In India, if we talk about our country, 1.5 to 2 lakh people die by suicide in India alone every year, making it almost one third of the complete suicides in the world. One third are happening in India. Hence, our country is almost the suicide capital of the world. तो एक बहुत ही अनफॉर्चुनेट बात है. suicide is among the top 10 leading causes of death in every country, and one of the three leading causes of death in 15 to 35 year old age group. Teen causes hote hain main 15 to 35 mein, accidental deaths, homicidal deaths, and third is the suicidal death. So you can see the statistics. It is not a rare thing. It is nothing that you can just ignore. It is happening every 40 seconds somewhere in the world. And our country has the maximum number of suicides every year in the world. And why to bother about it? You know, suicide and suicide attempts have a ripple effect. ये फैमिली को इम्पैक्ट करता है, फ्रेंड्स को इम्पैक्ट करता है, कॉलीग्स को इम्पैक्ट करता है, कम्युनिटीज को करता है, ना सोसाइटी एज ए होल को भी इम्पैक्ट करता है. सिंगल सुइसाइड अफेक्ट्स एटलीस्ट सिक्स अदर पीपल, एंड इफ देर इज अ सुइसाइड इन अ स्कूल और कॉलेज वेयर अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल आर ऑल्सो स्टडिंग, हंड्रेड्स आर अफेक्टेड बिकॉज ऑफ इट. नाउ वी टॉकिंग अबाउट ग्लोबल बर्डन ऑफ डिजीज, यू सी देर इज अ वे टू मेजर हाउ मच समथिंग इज हैविंग अ बर्डन on the healthcare system in terms of the dailies, you know, how much it is affecting us. The burden of suicide is equal to the burden of wars and homicide. It is twice the burden of diabetes currently in the world, and it is almost equal to the burden of birth asphyxia and trauma. So we can see how important it is to understand about it, to do something about it. Now, it is a multidimensional phenomenon. As we know already, a suicide leaves more questions than answers. It is a very, very complex issue. It has biological, genetic, psychological, sociological, environmental factors all acting in collaboration collectively to make a person reach a stage where the person decides to end his or her life. Coming to the risk factors, now we will be talking about the risk factors. What are the risk factors that can push a person towards suicide? Psychiatric disorders. That's why we say that suicides are preventable. If you treat them properly, probably the person will not end up committing a suicide. 80 to 90% of people who commit suicide have underlying mental health problem. 80 se 90% logo mein एक मानसिक रोग उस समय पर होता है जिस समय वो सुइसाइड अटेम्प्ट करते हैं, जिस समय वो सुइसाइड से खुद को खत्म करते हैं. जनरली डिप्रेशन 30 टू 50% के अंदर, अल्कोहलिज्म, सब्सटेंस यूज, दैट्स व्हाई सब्सटेंस यूज इन अल्कोहलिज्म इज सो इम्पॉर्टेंट टू बी ट्रीटेड बिकॉज इट लीड्स टू सुइसाइड ऑल्सो. इट्स अ वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रिस्क फैक्टर. स्किजोफ्रेनिया 3 टू 10% पीपल एंड पर्सनैलिटी डिसऑर्डर्स ऑल्सो कंट्रीब्यूट टू अ लॉट ऑफ रिस्क. If we talk about the lifetime risk of suicide in people suffering from mood disorders, be it depression, be it bipolar disorder, it is 6 to 15%. That means around 6 people to 15 people out of 100 people suffering from depression will ultimately end up committing suicide. And it's not a small number. Alcoholism 7 to 15%, schizophrenia 4 to 10%. So we can see how important it is to recognize that the illness part is also contributing to a great extent in suicide. Physical illness, not only mental health problems. If person is suffering from a physical illness, which is terminal, very painful, debilitating illness, like epilepsy or tumors, or patients on chronic diseases, liver disease, hemodialysis, you know, cancer, AIDS, they are all at risk of ending their life by suicide. Previous suicide attempts, one of the very important risk factors, or if the person was treated for mental health problem, he has been recently discharged from the hospital, then also there is a high risk of attempting it again. Family history of suicide, alcoholism, or any other psychiatric disorder. Divorced, widowed, or single status. So marriage has some protective effect on suicide, especially for males. Living alone or social isolation. You know, social isolation is also a very important risk factor. That's why we have been seeing that in this corona pandemic, there have been news of some people ending up their lives being confined to home due to the lockdown. Unemployed or retired person, financial problems, are at the root cause of many suicides, including farmer suicides as well. Bereavement in childhood. If somebody ends up losing his parent at around the age of 11 or 12, that also is considered a very significant risk factor. Bullying is another factor. Social isolation, as we discussed. Rejection or breakup in relationships also has been identified as a risk factor. Financial problems, exposure to suicides. So if somebody has committed suicide in the neighborhood or in the family, or media exposure of the suicide. So if you hear about the stories of suicide in media, that also results in copycat suicides when people end up ending their life, taking suicide as a reasonable alternative. Quality of childhood attachment, how is the attachment to the parental figures are. Poor problem-solving skills. These are also at the root cause of not being able to deal with the stress in life properly and going for the drastic step. Parental psychiatric disorder and substance abuse. Agar family mein kisi ko psychiatric disorder hai ya family mein koi alcohol leta hai ya substance abuse hai, toh that is also a risk factor. Family suicidal behavior by transmission of impulsive aggression. Some genetic factors are also responsible, like polymorphism in some TPH gene. That is also sometimes, some sort of it is also genetic. Exposure to violence and assaultive behavior is also a risk factor. Then shame and threat of being found guilty. Sometimes it is impulsive when a person is into a situation where he feels that he will be found guilty. So then they end up their life to reduce the shame that comes with it. Physical abuse, history of physical abuse, sexual abuse. Neurobiological risk factors are also there, like serotonin dysfunction, low concentration of a metabolite of serotonin, or the noradrenergic system dysfunction, HPA axis dysregulation. So all these things are all, you know, so you can see from this list that there are multiple factors which are responsible for a suicide to happen. So if you see that at this picture, you can realize that these are the factors. On the left, you can see genetics, some childhood traumatic events, then diathesis means vulnerability to a particular situation, sensitivity to stress, impulsivity, pessimism or hopelessness. Some people are particularly having these traits from the very beginning. Then the psychiatric disorders, mental health problems, then stresses in life, financial or marital problems, some emotional pain, breakup, all those things. All these things, they act in a very complex manner to result in suicidal behavior. So this is how it happens. It is not a simple one thing that, oh, he committed suicide because of this cause. It's nothing like that. There are always multiple factors involved. So now, coming to the important section, we have understood about the risk factors. What are the risk factors? Psychiatric disorders are the major risk factor, previous suicide attempts, then economic problems, marital problems, social isolation, and so forth. Now, coming to the warning signs. This is very important because we are talking about suicide prevention. If it starts from an individual, for an individual to understand what are the warning signs to look for. Kya dekhen kisi ke behavior mein, kisi ki baaton mein, jisse lage ki शायद ये इंसान सुइसाइड कर सकता है, ये चीज दिमाग में रखना बहुत जरूरी है. तो इसको आज हम लर्न करेंगे. वन, नंबर वन इज द रीसेंट सुइसाइड और डेथ बाय अदर मींस ऑफ अ फ्रेंड और अ रिलेटिव. किसी का फ्रेंड और रिलेटिव रिसेंटली डेथ हो गया बाय सुइसाइड और बाय एनी अदर मीन. देयर इज अ रीसेंट डेथ इन द फैमिली और फ्रेंडशिप. दैट इज अ वार्निंग साइन. Previous suicide attempts, a very, very important warning sign. Preoccupation with themes of death or expressing suicidal thoughts. If you find ki koi insaan bar bar marne ki baatein karta hai, agar main mar jata to acha hota, shayad mere jaane ke baad ye problem solve ho jayegi, main nahi hota to hi acha hota, ab kisi ko fikar karne ki zarurat nahi padegi. If somebody is talking like this, or if somebody is listening to songs or writing things which indicate the theme of death. Maut se judi hui cheezein likhna, maut se jude hue gaane sunna, maut se jude hue baatein karna, that means this is an important warning sign that the person is must be thinking about it. Otherwise, the person will not talk like this or behave like this. depression, if a person is depressed, or if you find that the substance use has increased, the person is into alcoholism or any other substance, that is also a warning sign. And he is talking about suicide. Giving away prized possessions, making a will or other final arrangement. If you find koi insaan ne apna will bana diya hai, abhi uski umar itni nahi hai, lekin achanak se usne apna will bana diya hai, usne apni cheeze logon ko dena shuru kar diya hai, that means he is preparing for the final act. Ye agar kisi mein notice kare to ye bhi ek bahut important warning sign hai. Major changes in sleep patterns. Bahut zyada koi so raha hai, bahut zyada jaag raha hai. Sudden and extreme changes in eating habits, losing or gaining weight. Basically these two things are part of depression. Jab koi depressed hota hai ya koi aur psychiatric disorder hota hai to sleep or eating behavior wo change ho jata hai. So agar main isko dobara se repeat kar dun taki aap logon ko dhyan rahe ye cheez, kisi ki family mein koi death hui ho, फ्रेंड की या रिलेटिव की, सुइसाइड से स्पेशली और अदरवाइज ऑल्सो, किसी ने पहले से सुसाइड अटेम्प्ट किए हो, कोई बार बार सुसाइड की बातें कर रहा हो गानों के द्वारा, पेंटिंग्स के द्वारा, या ऐसा कुछ एक्सप्रेस कर रहा हो, कोई बहुत ज्यादा नशे की लत में चला गया हो, कोई अपनी विल बना रहा है, अपनी चीजों को बांट रहा है, एज इफ ही इज प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर द फाइनल एक्ट. स्लीप में और ईटिंग हैबिट्स में बहुत ड्रेस्टिक चेंजेस आ गए हैं. So that person needs to be taken seriously. That person needs help. Other warning signs are withdrawal from friends or family or other major behavioral changes. आपको लगे किसी के बिहेवियर में अचानक से चेंजेस आ गए हैं, वो विड्रॉ कर गया है, ज्यादा बात नहीं करता, ज्यादा नहीं बोलता, चुप रहने लगा है, अपने अपने में रहने लगा है, अक्सर कमरे को बंद रखता है, कोई और मेजर बिहेवियरल चेंजेस जो आपने बिहेवियर में नोट किए हों. Dropping out of group activities. पहले participate करता था, सबके साथ बैठता था, अब नहीं बैठता है, नहीं participate करता है. कुछ और personality changes like nervous होने लग गया है, अचानक से गुस्सा आ जाता है, outbursts of anger, impulsiveness और reckless behavior. और ऐसा लगे apathy about appearance or health. कि उसको अपनी उसको पड़ी नहीं है कि वो कैसा दिख रहा है, कितने दिन से नहाया है, नहीं नहाया है, अपना ध्यान ठीक से नहीं रख रहा है. ये आप लोगों को आसानी से दिख जाएंगी चीजें अगर आप अच्छे से ऑब्जर्व करेंगे. ये भी साइंस हैं कि वो बंदे को, उस इंसान को हेल्प की जरूरत है. फ्रीक्वेंट इरिटेबिलिटी और अनएक्सप्लेन्ड क्राइंग. बहुत ज्यादा अचानक से चिड़चिड़ापन बढ़ जाना, अचानक से रोने लग जाना जिसका कोई रीजन ही ना हो. लिंगरिंग एक्सप्रेशंस ऑफ अनवर्दीनेस ऑफ फेलियर. जैसा मैंने पहले बताया, अक्सर इस तरीके की बातें करना कि मैंने जिंदगी में कुछ नहीं किया, आई एम अ फेलियर, मैं कुछ नहीं कर पाया, मैं बर्डन हूँ, आई एम अ बर्डन, मैं एक बोझ हूँ सबके ऊपर, इस टाइप की बातें बार बार किसी का करना. लैक ऑफ इंटरेस्ट इन द फ्यूचर, होपलेसनेस, कुछ सही नहीं होने वाला, कुछ भी ठीक नहीं होगा, इस टाइप से बातें करना. या फिर ऐसा लगे कि एक इंसान, ये सब हो रहा था उसके साथ, पहले वो बहुत उदास था, पहले वो ऐसी निराशा की बातें करता था, और अचानक से बहुत खुश दिख रहा है, बहुत कंटेंटेड दिख रहा है, वो भी एक वार्निंग साइन है कि उसने डिसाइड कर लिया है कि अब तो मुझे मर जाना है. जब इंसान डिसाइड कर लेता है तो उसको लगता है ये सब खत्म हो जाएगा, तो वो रिलैक्स फील करता है. वो भी एक वार्निंग साइन है कि समटाइम्स सडनली उसका एकदम से उसका चीयरफुल हो जाना, उसका रिलैक्स हो जाना, ये भी इंडिकेट करता है कि उसने शायद वो फाइनल डिसीजन ले लिया है. तो ये भी एक वार्निंग साइन है. तो हम जब इतना हमने देखा कि सुसाइड इतना कॉमन है कि हर 40 सेकंड में एक इंसान की मौत हो रही है, हमारे देश में 1.5 से 2 लाख लोग हर साल इससे मर रहे हैं, फिर हम इसके बारे में ज्यादा बात क्यों नहीं करते, इसके बारे में इतना साइलेंस क्यों है? उसका कारण है स्टिग्मा. There are a lot of myths associated with suicide and there is a lot of stigma attached to suicide. और इसकी वजह से हम हमेशा इसके बारे में बात नहीं करते, बट इसके बारे में क्यूरियोसिटी बहुत रखते हैं. जब ये हो जाता है तो आप देखोगे कि मीडिया के अंदर भी जब हो जाएगा सुइसाइड, उसके बाद उसके बारे में बहुत बातें की जाएंगी जो कि गलत है. हम इसको रोकने के बारे में बातें नहीं करते, हम इसके होने के बाद क्यों हुआ, कैसे हुआ, क्या रीजंस रहे होंगे, इनके बारे में हम बातें करते हैं और उसको तरह तरह की नजरिए से देखते हैं. तो जो मिथ्स एंड स्टिग्मा है सुसाइड के साथ, एक मिथ ये आ गया है कि अगर इसके बारे में बात करेंगे तो ये रिस्की है, इसके बारे में बात ही मत करो, डू नॉट टॉक अबाउट इट। अगर आप ऐसे बात करोगे तो शायद आप ही सुसाइड कर लोगे या कोई और किसी को आइडिया मिल जाएगा। आई विल टॉक अबाउट इट इन मिथ्स दैट इज अ रॉन्ग थिंग। सो एक्यूरेट इन्फॉर्मेशन नहीं है, देर इज नो एक्यूरेट इन्फॉर्मेशन, देर आर मिथ्स, देर इज अ स्टिग्मा अटैच्ड एंड हेंस पीपल मोस्टली डू नॉट टॉक अबाउट इट। वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट इट, यू नो वॉट हैज हैपेंड फ्यू मंथ्स बैक, दैट्स वाई देर इज अ लॉट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट इन पीपल दीज डेज रिगार्डिंग सुइसाइड, अदरवाइज हम शायद ये बात भी नहीं कर रहे होते। That's why there is a suicide prevention day, because people ignore it, they don't talk about it. So coming to, I will be explaining certain myths and facts. कुछ मैं myths बताऊंगा कि क्या क्या भ्रांतियां हैं suicide के बारे में, और फिर उनके facts बताऊंगा कि सही बात क्या है। पहला myth है, most suicides happen suddenly without warning. This is a myth. Actual में majority of suicides are preceded by warning signs. Warning signs वही जो हमने अभी डिस्कस किए थे, whether verbal or behavioral, there are always some warning signs in majority of suicides. हाँ, कुछ suicides होते हैं, there are few suicides that happen without warning also, they are impulsive, but otherwise majority of suicides are preceded by warning signs, and that's why it is important to understand and recognize the warning signs so that the person can be helped. Another myth is, it's not a big problem, suicide is not all that common, and we have seen how common it is. It is third largest cause of death in young people and one of the 10 leading causes of death in all countries. So it is very, very common, and it's not a problem that you can just ignore. Another myth, only a certain people are at risk for suicide. It would not be anyone I know. All people I know are doing well. That means it cannot happen to me or anybody I know. I know all my people, all my family members, all my friends are well settled. They are not at risk for suicide. This is not true. Anybody can be at risk. Seemingly successful, जो आपको लगता है कि ये बहुत successful है, बहुत happy है, उसको भी ऐसा हो सकता है. इसलिए don't ignore the warning signs. Recognizing the warning signs in otherwise successful individual is also very important. Another myth is, someone who talks about suicide will never do it. This is a very common myth. कि जो बात कर रहा है मरने की वो उसको करेगा नहीं, ये सिर्फ बोलता है करता नहीं है. This is wrong. Actually, कोई क्यों बात करता है मरने के बारे में? Why does somebody talk about taking that step? Because that person wants help. That person is seeking help. वो एक मदद के लिए गुहार है, और ये बहुत लेट साइन होता है. इट्स अ लेट साइन इन द प्रोग्रेशन टुवर्ड्स द सुसाइड अटेम्प्ट. जब ऑलमोस्ट लास्ट स्टेज में होता है, देन द पर्सन स्टार्ट्स टॉकिंग अबाउट सुसाइड. सो वी शुड नेवर एवर टेक इट लाइटली. अनदर मिथ इज, इफ यू विल टॉक अबाउट समवन, टॉक अबाउट सुसाइड टू समवन, और वेदर द पर्सन हैज अ सुसाइडल आइडिया और समथिंग, you may give them an idea to try it. ये बहुत common myth है कि अगर मैं किसी से suicide के बारे में बात करूंगा तो उसको idea मिल जाएगा, अगर वो नहीं सोच रहा होगा तो भी सोचने लग जाएगा. This is a myth. ऐसा नहीं होता है. Fact ये है कि when you talk to someone regarding suicide or any plan to commit suicide, that person gets an opportunity to share their disturbing thoughts. उनको एक मौका मिलता है अपनी बात कहने का, उनको एक मौका मिलता है अपनी एंजाइटी को कम करने का, और कुछ अल्टरनेटिव थॉट्स भी दिमाग में आ सकते हैं, इससे सुसाइड का रिस्क कम हो जाता है. सो इफ यू सस्पेक्ट वार्निंग साइंस इन समवन, यू हैव टू टॉक अबाउट इट टू द पर्सन. मैं आपको बताऊंगा बात कैसे करनी है आगे. अनदर मिथ इज कि आजकल सुइसाइड हेल्पलाइन होते हैं, हमारे देश में भी हैं, कई सारे ऑर्गेनाइजेशन सुइसाइड हेल्पलाइन प्रोवाइड कर रहे हैं. कि किसी को अगर लग रहा है ऐसा वार्निंग साइन, तो उसको सुइसाइड हेल्पलाइन नंबर दे दो, फिर वो ठीक हो जाएगा, अपने आप बात कर लेगा, सब ठीक हो जाएगा. दिस इज अगेन अ मिथ. द फैक्ट इज दैट द पर्सन माइट बी स्ट्रगलिंग सो मच. वो इतना एक्सक्रूशिएटिंग पेन में होता है, इतना स्ट्रगल कर रहा होता है, कि उसमें वो एनर्जी ही नहीं होती वो आपका दिया हुआ नंबर डायल करे और किसी से बात करे. इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट इज यू हैव टू बी देयर फॉर द नेक्स्ट स्टेप. आप उसकी बात कराइए, आप उसके डॉक्टर से बात करिए, उसको अपने डॉक्टर के टच में लेके आइए, उसकी फैमिली से बात करिए इफ ही इज स्टेइंग अलोन. अगर वो तैयार नहीं हो रहा है तो खुद उसको लेके जाइए. दिस इज वॉट अ इंडिविजुअल हैज टू डू. सो प्रोवाइडिंग अ नंबर और जस्ट गिविंग अ हिंट इज नॉट सफिशिएंट, क्योंकि उसके अंदर वो एनर्जी वो स्ट्रेंथ ही नहीं होती कि वो आपकी कही हुई बात को फॉलो कर सके. अनदर मिथ, वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट मिथ, और मुझे लगता है आप बहुत सारे लोगों ने ये सुना भी होगा और देखा भी होगा, दैट सुइसाइडल बिहेवियर्स आर जस्ट अटेंशन सीकिंग. इट इज बेटर जस्ट टू इग्नोर इट. ये कुछ नहीं है, ये कुछ करने वाला नहीं है, ये सिर्फ धमकी देता है, या ये जो उसने बिहेवियर किया है सिर्फ अटेंशन गेन करने के लिए किया है. इट इज अ मिथ, ये गलत है, ऐसा नहीं होता है. मैंने बताया सुइसाइड अटेम्प्ट इज ऑफन अ क्राई फॉर हेल्प, वो मदद के लिए गुहार है. जब इंसान को कुछ और नहीं सूझ रहा, वो इतना बीमार है, इतना फंसा हुआ है उस सिचुएशन के अंदर, कि वो एक अटेम्प्ट करता है कि शायद मेरी कोई मदद करे. तो अगर उसको अटेंशन मिल भी रहा है इस एक्ट के थ्रू, इस अटेंशन से हम उसकी जान बचा सकते हैं. सो इवन इफ द पर्सन इज गेटिंग अटेंशन थ्रू द एक्ट, दिस अटेंशन कैन सेव हिज और हर लाइफ. So never ever dismiss it as just attention seeking. Another myth is if they are considering suicide, there is nothing I can do. Agar kisi ne decide kar hi liya hai ki mujhe mar jana hai, to fir main kya kar sakta hu? The fact is, jaisa maine bataya ki 80 to 90% ke andar underlying causes hote hain, koi disorder hota hai, koi substance use hota hai, koi aur situation hoti hai, and these things can be treated. उसका इलाज हो सकता है, उसको हम प्रिवेंट कर सकते हैं. पीपल कैन बी हेल्प्ड, क्योंकि सुइसाइडल क्राइसिस कैन बी रिलेटिवली शॉर्ट लिव्ड. अगर किसी को सुइसाइड का थॉट आ रहा है तो वो उसको हमेशा के लिए नहीं आएगा. इट इज अ वेरी शॉर्ट लिव्ड सिचुएशन. अगर वो क्राइसिस डिफ्यूज हो गया उस टाइम पे, वो मोमेंट चला गया, फिर दोबारा से पूरी उम्मीद है अगर वो पर्सन ठीक से हेल्प ले कि वो एक लंबी जिंदगी जिए और फिर से अटेम्प्ट ना करे. ऐसे बहुत सारे लोग हैं जिनको मैं भी जानता हूं पर्सनली, जिन्होंने कभी सुसाइड अटेम्प्ट किया होगा, बट नाउ दे आर लिविंग अ फ्रूटफुल लाइफ, अ जॉयफुल लाइफ. एंड आई नो पीपल ऑल्सो हु हैव डन इट 50 इयर्स बैक और 40 इयर्स बैक, एंड दे लिव्ड अ फुलफिलिंग लॉन्ग लाइफ बिकॉज समवन वाज देयर हु कुड गेट देम द हेल्प दे नीडेड. सो इमीडिएट प्रैक्टिकल हेल्प सच एज स्टेइंग विद द पर्सन, encouraging them to talk, and helping them getting the help they need. All this can help. So never ever consider that if somebody is considering suicide, then there is nothing I can do. We can do a lot. Another myth is people who want to die always find a way. That means if a person is determined to die, they are determined to die. It is also wrong. The fact is, most of the people who are suicidal are often ambivalent. वो जिंदगी और मौत के बीच में झूल रहे होते हैं. They are torn between the desire to live and the desire to die. Last moment तक, the ambivalence is there in most of the people. So it can be helped. Another very important myth and very common myth to address is that people who commit suicide are weak. वो कमजोर था इसलिए उसने सुइसाइड कर लिया. मैं कमजोर नहीं हूं, मेरी फैमिली में तो कोई कमजोर नहीं है. इट्स सच अ इग्नोरेंट एंड इनसेंसिटिव मिथ. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, आई जस्ट आस्क यू, इफ समबडी इज डाइंग ऑफ कैंसर, विल यू से दैट द पर्सन इज वीक? इफ समबडी डाइड ऑफ अ हार्ट अटैक, will you say that the person was weak? No, right? Because you think they were having an illness. But understand this fact very well, that most of the people who commit suicide, 90% of them are having an illness. They are suffering. They are having excruciating emotional pain. Their thinking is not clear. That's why they took that step. They were not weak. They were ill. वो बीमार थे, वो weak नहीं थे. So this has to be taken away. This is the most stigmatizing myth that we have. We have to stop talking about suicide in weak or strong terms. We just have to accept that it is a complex phenomenon. People are ill and sometimes it ends up like suicide. It's an outcome of an illness, right? Like cancer or heart attack. Another myth, if we're talking about suicide prevention, you may assume to think that every suicidal death is preventable. So again, I will say the same thing. We cannot prevent all cardiac deaths. Despite the best treatment, we cannot prevent all deaths happening from cancer. Despite the best treatment, we cannot prevent all deaths happening from stroke or diabetes. In the same manner, even with the sincerest and diligent efforts, we cannot prevent all suicides. It's an outcome of a complex process. We can try to stop it. We can try to prevent it. In majority of the cases, we can be successful also. But even then, there would be some cases where you have to assume that we could not control it. Like we do in all other cases of death due to some other reasons. Coming to stigma part of it, it's a taboo to talk about suicide. It is a taboo to admit suicidal thought. That's why people remain silent. They don't express and we miss the warning signs. What should be done for that? The stigma has to be reduced and there has to be an open discussion and awareness regarding suicide and prevention of suicide. So what can one individual do about it? What can you do about it as an individual? There are three steps we can do. One is listening empathetically, asking the question, and getting help for the person. I will explain all these three in detail, what one individual can do to prevent suicide. Listening is the most important part. Even the mere act of listening, if you are there with the person, if you are listening to the person, even the mere act of listening may reduce suicidal impulsivity and thoughts. That can be reduced. Be open and patient. Listen for the meaning behind the words. And start with open-ended questions. What is an open-ended question? Like, you seem to be upset. Can you tell me more about it? This is an open-ended question that will give the person a chance to begin the conversation. It usually sets the stage for rapport building. So this is very, very important. Being there, listening empathetically, and starting with open-ended questions. This is the second stage. You have recognized the warning signs. Now you are with the individual. This is the way to talk. Support their being open about suicide. If the person expresses suicidal thoughts, don't judge the person. Just tell the person that I'm glad that you could trust me to share what you were thinking about. Don't minimize their pain. Nothing will happen. Don't worry about it. These are not the things to say. Just provide empathy. Understand, try to understand what the person is going through. And if you do not know what to say, just listen. Mere act of being there and listening is good enough to begin with. Don't try to fix the problems. Just listen. Then when the rapport has been built, when the person is sharing, when the person is feeling open enough to share the feelings, then ask the question directly. Are you thinking of suicide? If the person says yes, ask in details. Do you have a plan for it? Have you thought? What are you going to do for it? And if you come to know about it, if the person shares that, remove all the harmful objects from the environment, disable any immediate plan, offer support and compassion that I'm there with you, be with the person, don't leave the person alone. And most importantly, the third part, get help. Don't try to do it all alone. Never keep it as a secret that somebody told you about it, you kept it to yourself. No. You have to explore resources, offer to assist in help seeking, arrange for proper help, involve the family, friends, medical fraternity in providing the best help for the person. This is how these three things are done: listening, asking the question, and getting help. Remember, anyone can be at risk for suicide. Take warning signs seriously. Listen, ask, get help. These are the three steps. And take care of yourself as well. Now, coming to some protective factors for suicide, these are also part of prevention of suicide. What are the protective factors which prevent suicide from happening? You know, these are very important steps for overall strategy making for suicide prevention. Number one is effective clinical care for mental and physical and substance use disorder. If somebody is suffering from any mental health issue, depression, bipolar, schizophrenia, or any physical health issue, if they have proper care available, accessible, then the chances are reduced. Easy access to a variety of clinical interventions and support for help seeking. Restricted access to highly lethal means of suicide. In that way, non-availability of guns, regulating the sale of pesticides, you know, all these things come under restricted access to highly lethal means. In India, another important issue is you go to the chemist and you can buy any amount of sleeping pills if you want. They will not even ask for a prescription. So this has to be regulated as well. People should not get access to medicines also, which can be lethal in higher doses without a proper prescription. Connectedness to family. It has been found in research that if the person is connected to the family, there is a good communication pattern in the family, then that also acts as a preventive factor for suicide. Better stress resilience, good coping and problem solving skills, belief system. If you have cultural and religious beliefs that discourage suicide and promote self-preservation, this should also be encouraged. Positive beliefs and values and spiritual connectedness. Responsibility for children. In my own practice, I find many people who express suicidal thoughts. And the most important protective factor that comes is that I cannot do it because I have kids. Mere bacche hain, main ye nahi kar sakta. Mera man to bahut karta hai, lekin main kar nahi sakta. So responsibility for children. Again, the connectedness thing. If you are connected to your family, if there is cohesiveness in the family, then even if the thought comes, you will not act on it. Presence of a significant other. कोई भी हो आपकी लाइफ में जिससे आपका बहुत गहरा रिश्ता हो, अगर ऐसा होता है तो भी सुइसाइड के चांसेस कम हो जाते हैं. गुड फिजिकल एंड मेंटल हेल्थ. कम्युनिटी एंड सोशल इंटीग्रेशन. एक ऐसी कम्युनिटी, एक ऐसी सोसाइटी जहां पे कोहेसिवनेस है, जहां पे कनेक्टेड है पीपल, वहां भी पीपल एंड अप गेटिंग सम सॉर्ट ऑफ सपोर्ट एंड दे डोंट टेक दिस पाथ. Economic stability and security, again, a very, very important factor. So, coming to suicide prevention, it is a complex public health problem. You have seen it, how complex are the warning signs, how complex are the risk factors associated with suicide. So, prevention and control is not so easy, and it involves a whole series of activities. Number one is awareness. That's why we are talking about it. If you are not aware of that suicide can be prevented, why would we act in the direction of prevention? So this awareness and dissemination of information regarding suicide, why suicide happens, what can be the various factors, what are the warning signs, this is a very, very important step in suicide prevention. Now, coming to role of an individual in suicide prevention, what you can do as an individual. I discussed some of it initially. I'll again emphasize on it. Number one, आप एक सुइसाइड प्रिवेंशन के योद्धा बन जाते हो, एक सोल्जर बन जाते हो द मोमेंट यू आर अवेयर अबाउट द वेरियस फैक्ट्स ऑफ सुइसाइड. becoming aware of facts about suicide makes one a vital partner in suicide prevention in our community. आपको पता है सुइसाइड के वार्निंग साइंस क्या हैं, आपको पता है सुइसाइड के बारे में गलत क्या है, सही क्या है, आप इसको स्प्रेड कर सकते हो, आप लोगों को बता सकते हो, आप खुद को समझा सकते हो, एंड देन दिस वे द सुइसाइड प्रिवेंशन स्टार्ट्स इन अ कम्युनिटी. सो हेल्पिंग इन अवेयरनेस रेजिंग अबाउट सुइसाइड प्रिवेंशन एंड रिड्यूसिंग स्टिग्मा, इस तरीके से आप इससे जुड़ा हुआ स्टिग्मा जो कलंक है उसको भी कम कर सकते हो. यू कैन आइडेंटिफाई वार्निंग साइंस, you can seek help, you can promote, offer, assist the person to seek help. You can learn good parenting skills. For better stress management, you can learn stress management skills, conflict resolution skills to prevent reaching to a state in your life or helping people around you from reaching that state. Seeking timely help for mental or physical or substance use disorder. If you find that you are suffering from any physical health problem or mental health problem, or you are into substance use like alcohol, drugs, or anything, you can seek timely help. And if you seek timely help, you are helping in suicide prevention. Role of society as a whole and government. Because I told you it is a multidimensional issue. So everyone has to come on board, the society, individual, government, organizations. We all have to work collectively for suicide prevention. So the number one thing is, if you talk about suicide prevention, it starts in childhood. So when we provide the best possible conditions to raise our children and youth, we are protecting them from suicide in the future. Value-based education system, that's where the role of schools comes and building of a cohesive society. Inculcation of good coping skills and frustration tolerance from the very beginning. When we are saying no to your child, then the child is throwing tantrums. You are saying no to some of the demands which may not be appropriate for the time. You are building stress resilience and frustration tolerance in your kid. जब जिंदगी आगे जाके मना करेगी किसी चीज के लिए, आप उसके लिए उसको तैयार कर रहे हो. दिस इज हाउ सुइसाइड प्रिवेंशन स्टार्ट्स इन चाइल्डहुड. वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फैक्ट. अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ इफेक्टिव ट्रीटमेंट, दिस इज द रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी ऑफ सोसाइटी एंड गवर्नमेंट. मेंटल हेल्थ, फिजिकल हेल्थ, सब्सटेंस यूज, सबके लिए इफेक्टिव ट्रीटमेंट की सुविधा होनी चाहिए, इंक्लूडिंग सुइसाइड हेल्पलाइंस एंड क्राइसिस इंटरवेंशन सेंटर्स. Optimum economic and financial opportunities and support system in the society for individuals and families. Control of lethal means of suicide like guns, pesticides, medicines. Asani se availability nahi honi chahiye. Avoiding glorification of suicide in media. Very, very important fact. You might all have witnessed it in the last 2 months or 3 months. How media reports suicide. So there is a guideline for media to report suicide and they should follow it. And rather, media should be engaged for suicide prevention steps. Training of people for crisis intervention, be their healthcare staff, school teachers, parents, people working in emergencies, they all should be trained for it. So take home message for today's talk. One is, suicides are preventable. Second, awareness and identification of warning signs and helping to get help is crucial. तो warning signs को समझना और किसी की help करना, अगर आपको warning signs मिल गए उस individual के अंदर, तो उसकी help करो help लेने में. That is also very crucial. और आप start कर सकते हो, you can just start helping just by being there and listening. This is the starting point. And suicide prevention is a collective value-driven endeavor. It should inspire hope, meaning, and purpose. Uplift the overall society, preserving dignity, countering stigma, stereotypes, discrimination. Supporting people, families, and communities so that everyone experiences a life that's worth living. This is how, you know, in the short term and in the long term, suicide prevention can be possible. Before I finish my talk, I'll say a couplet by Nida Fazli. It's very close to my heart. Munh ki baat sune har koi, dil ke dard ko jaane kaun. मुंह की बात सुने हर कोई, दिल के दर्द को जाने कौन, आवाजों के बाजारों में खामोशी पहचाने कौन। सो यू सी मोस्ट ऑफ द पीपल हु आर स्ट्रगलिंग विद मेंटल हेल्थ इश्यूज, दे आर सफरिंग इन साइलेंस। देयर इज अ नीड टू रिकॉग्नाइज दैट सफरिंग एंड टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट मेंटल हेल्थ मैटर्स। थैंक यू सो मच।
थैंक यू सर। I guess World Suicide Prevention Day पे इसे apt और इसे to the point session हो नहीं सकता था।
Thank you so much for your kind words।
काफी नई चीजें हमें पता चली और काफी view changing चीजें भी थी इसमें।
Right.
So now that we are live on Facebook as well as on Zoom, I would request if our participants have any question, they can put on chat on Facebook as well as on Zoom, and I guess Dr. Madhusudan will be happy to help.
Sure, definitely.
Sir, meanwhile we get some question. I have one question on my WhatsApp.
Please.
Can you guide or help with any particular habit that one should adopt to ensure that if we do that habit or activity, we may get some relief in terms of negativity or depression, or if we get any suicidal thought, we can get some relief by doing that activity on a daily basis or a weekly basis?
See, it's very difficult to point out a single habit for that purpose, but a collection of habits can take you to a spot in life where you have more stress resilience. Basically, it is about building stress resilience. When life is not kind to us at that time, how do we deal with things? You know, so there are a few things which really help in it. One is connecting to your spiritual side, practicing something on a daily basis which connects you to a larger, you know, something beyond yourself, to your family, to your community. Practicing gratefulness, practicing healthy lifestyle like exercising, yoga and pranayama, and working on your problem solving skills. You know, if you know how to solve your problems, how to approach your problems, if you work on that, that is also one of the things that can reduce stress that you experience in your life. Investing in relationships, nurturing your relationships, nurturing yourself with good food. So all these things are important in making you stress resilient. And understanding this very important fact that suicide is not the solution. It may seem like one when you are in that state. So recognizing the warning signs, seeking help when you need it, when you realize that I am going through something and I'm not able to deal with it. So that openness to seek help, if you inculcate this in yourself, that it is okay to seek help. It is okay to share your feelings. It is okay to talk about it. All this can go to a great extent in, you know, resolving crisis situations in your life, in making you feel supported. And that's all we need to live a joyful, meaningful, and fulfilling life, because the problems will be there. The life will be unpredictable. The problems will be there. What kind of resources I am generating, you know? What kind of resources I'm inculcating, nurturing in the long run to become better at dealing with the lows of life when they come, you know? So it has been seen that people who are having habit of better problem solving skills, or they have not been very impulsive with things, or they have been a little spiritual in their approach to life, they often feel connected and grateful. They have a good network of people around them. They invest in their relationships. All the protective factors that we talked about, they have a good relationship with their children or with their parents, you know, or as a society, there is a cohesiveness there. All these things, they help us you know, living a life which is worth living. So it's not a simple answer. I know I talked a lot of things, but in nutshell, if you say practicing a healthy lifestyle, connecting to your family, investing in your relationships, building your stress resilient skills, you know, learning problem solving skills, changing your maladaptive coping skills to good ones, and not taking the help of alcohol, substance or drugs to deal with stress. All these things go a long way. And one more thing, देखो इतनी सारी चीजें हैं कि मुझे बार-बार उसको concise करने में बड़ी problem आ रही है, but not hesitating to seek help when it is needed. That is the most important part, because in mental health area, you know how much stigma is there. People do not come out, they do not seek help. Even medical professionals, they do not come out. There is so much of stigma attached to it, as if your brain or the mind has come with a lifetime warranty and every other thing can fail in your body. For example, your liver can fail and your digestion can be affected, your kidneys can fail and you can be on hemodialysis, but the mind will work as it was when you were born. So it doesn't work like that. It's the most complex organ in our body, and thinking, feeling, emotions, these are all functions of the brain. So very subtle changes, they may come and they require proper treatment, proper therapy, help, and should be obtained. We should be open enough to seek that, right? Right, so that is also a very, very important step.
Right, sir. And like you said, people don't seek help. We have one question. People don't get convinced to reach psychiatrists. How do we convince them that they need help?
Okay, so the thing is that it is not about just seeking help from a psychiatrist. You know, where it begins is that when you sit with the person, do you have a connect with the person first? Whosoever is convincing a person needs to build that rapport first. It's not just about seeking help from a psychiatrist. The intervention begins when somebody is there to sit with the person. The person may not open up, may not be convinced in the first meeting or the second meeting, but if you spend some time, if you are non-judgmental, if you are really willing to help, you will be there with the person. Gradually, the bridge will be built. The person will share more. Probably a point will come when you will get the person ready to seek help, not from a psychiatrist, then seek help from your family physician or even from the psychologists. So if there is a stigma around psychiatry, you can start from somewhere else and then reach the spot where the person needs to be. So it all begins with the person who is trying to convince. Is the person ready to put in those many efforts to do it? Because of the prevalent stigma and myths surrounding mental health, it is actually difficult to get these things done. But if you persist on it, it can happen.
Thank you, sir. We have one question on Facebook. How to ensure a good mental health of elderly people who stay alone?
See, definitely, it's an unfortunate situation that elderly people have to stay alone. You know, when you have all the time of the world with you, when you are retired and you have nobody to talk to, you have nobody around you. So it's an unfortunate situation, but actually elderly people should try to mix with people of their own age. They should form a group virtually. In these days, it is virtually only possible, but if they can involve themselves in some community activities, some part of their day is devoted to interacting with the people of their own age. If the children can remain in touch by frequent visits, if they can talk to their parents on a daily basis, if they can motivate them to do something for them, even virtual calls or video calls, you know, so they remain connected with their children also, and they involve themselves into some sort of community activity, you know, meeting with like-minded people or the same age people. All these things can reduce. And another thing I want to tell you, we will all get older. you know, Dipesh, me, you, everybody will get older. What are we preparing for that? Again, this comes as a stress building, you know, technique or training or something. Are we preparing for our old age? Am I preparing myself for my post-retirement life? What am I doing for that? Am I developing some kind of interests, hobbies? I'm nurturing certain things which will help me, you know, relax and focus and derive meaning and joy out of life once I am no more working in this capacity. So that is also very important. We are not focusing on what to do when the children are raised, when they are no more in the home. What will you do? Nobody is working on that. And if the people work on that, they are fine in their old age. If they do not, they face a lot of difficulties because age-old habits, they do not change easily. So there is also a preventive strategy to it, that all the people who are now in their 30s and 40s, they should also think about their post-retirement life. They should invest time into relationships, into hobbies, into nurturing some sort of skills or things which you can do when you have a lot of time to do all those things. You know, investing in healthy lifestyle, all these things are very, very important. So it is about the people who are right now alone. We can do things to a limited extent, but still we can do that. Second, people who are not in that state, but they will reach one day in that state, they should also prepare for it right now. So great. This is how it goes, right?
So a person has put on our Facebook page, how do I get this thought out of my mind that it will be peaceful to end life?
See, again, I told you why this thought is coming in the mind in the first place. You know, maybe I'm not in the right frame of mind, number one. Maybe my thinking is compromised because of the severe depression I am feeling, or I think suicide is the only way out from this pain. You know, the first question is, why am I thinking like that? And because the answer to this question, that after suicide, everything will be peaceful. I don't know anybody who came back after suicide and told me that it was very peaceful after suicide. I don't know anybody. Do you know anybody? Nobody knows anybody. You know, what we know is that suicide is as mysterious as life and death itself. And no one knows what happens after death. We don't know about that solution. So it is not a solution. There is no guarantee that there is peace. But what we have to think about is, why am I thinking like that? Why the person is thinking like that, that it will be peaceful after dying? What can be changed in life? Is there a problem the person is facing? Is there a mental health problem? Is there a physical health problem? Is there any other preventable factor that can be modified in the person's life so that the thinking process comes from leaving this life to living this life? You know, so all this is how it can be approached.
Right, sir. So one question is, I can see someone in my vicinity who has the suicidal symptoms that you shared, but he is extremely aggressive. If I try to speak with him, it's almost I'm touching a shame wound. What can one do if someone wants to stay isolated and doesn't allow connections?
Very, very important question. And the answer to this question is again a collective effort. You know, it's unfortunate that we don't have social services of that accord in our country, where people can reach out and people of this type who are isolated, who do not want to seek help, can be helped from organizations and governments. You know, because a person who is a neighbor is in a limited capacity to help. Right. But still, what the person can try is that they should involve the family, the extended family or friends if they are available. They should be talked to. They should be conveyed the concerns that the person has observed regarding this person, and probably with the intervention of the relatives and the family, because in India, family system is the most important social support system. Probably some sense may prevail and the person may accept help, which he is denying currently from a neighbor or an acquaintance. So this way it can be approached. But for the long term, I again stress, we need kind of organizations and social services where people who do not have a support system, who do not have a family, who are isolated, can be helped. We need to build these resources in the long run.
Right, sir. One question from Dr. C.K. Mate. Is somebody with paranoia traits be more likely to have suicidal tendency?
Very pertinent question. See, I told you that schizophrenia, people who are suffering from schizophrenia, paranoia basically occurs in the context of psychosis. When you are not in touch with reality, right? So people who are suffering from psychosis, if they are paranoid, there can be delusional beliefs. Delusion is a strong belief, firm belief, which you cannot change and which is wrong. You know, it's a wrong, false belief, but it is a very strong and firm. So at times, the delusional beliefs may make the person reach to the point where a person feels that I am in danger, people are going to harm me, I may be shamed, there may be news all over about me. All these kind of delusional thinking may come and cloud the thinking process, and person may, you know, harm himself. That can happen, yes. That's why people in schizophrenia, mostly when the delusions are very strong, they end up harming themselves.
Right, sir. One question is getting repeated, so I'm asking, how do we protect children of a person who had suicidal thoughts?
Okay, very important question. The thing is, who are we in this? That's also very important to define. You know, and if the children are there, the person is alone, or the person has a spouse who can be, you know, convinced to make the person seek help. Most important part is you can protect the children by making the person to seek help. You know, how we can do that? That is what we have to think. If a person is aggressive, violent, or suicidal, the person needs to be properly treated, maybe admitted for a while. If the person is in that state where he can harm others or himself, that way, by ensuring the right kind of treatment and intervention, we can protect the children also. So it is very important to take on board the family, the spouse of the person, the extended family, whosoever is there available as a resource to take care of kids during the time the person is being managed for the suicidal behavior.
Right, sir. One question, how to identify the gravity of the person undergoing the crisis?
By observing the warning signs, as we discussed.
Right. One question, what is the connection between childhood trauma and suicidal tendencies?
See, childhood trauma has a very strong connection to a lot of, to many mental health disorders, including depression, post-traumatic stress disorder, and many personality disorders, you know. So childhood trauma plays a role in these disorders, and these disorders, they play a role in suicidal tendencies. So definitely there is a connection. There is a link.
So one question, can a RMP write psychiatric medicine?
See, RMP, I assume we are talking about MBBS doctors, right? Mm-hmm. So they are the first line of defense if we talk about, because most of the people visit them initially. So they should be trained, number one, in recognizing the warning signs, interviewing a suicidal patient, and they can initially prescribe, if they are trained in that thing, they can initially prescribe some antidepressants and then refer the person for psychiatric help, because suicide is not to be taken lightly. So if expert health is available, it should be availed, and the person should be guided for the same.
Right, sir. I guess these were the question. One question, how do I communicate to my family that I am seeking a mental health professional when the family itself has stigma against seeking mental health?
that's the fight is. That's what we are talking about today. You know, there is so much of stigma that people are fighting it on individual level, on the level of family, on the level of community, society, organizations. But I will suggest only one thing, that if you are seeking help for mental health disorders, you should do it, regardless of what your family feels about it.
Right, sir. So that was the last question. Sir, last take-home message.
One more thing, Dipesh, I would like to add. If the family is, literate family, there are many resources available online which talk about how mental health suffers and what are the various mental health disorders. And if the person recognizes himself or herself as having a particular mental disorder, they should, you know, share these details with the family, with details of the treatment. And if he or she is seeking help from someone, a psychiatrist or a psychologist, he should bring the family on board to meet with the treating physician or psychiatrist so that they can ask their questions, if doubts, any doubts if they have in their mind. That way, it will be easier for him to get the family on board.
Right, sir. So was it last message on the day?
Last message is that suicide is preventable. We should all remember this one thing in our mind. Number two, suicide is a complex phenomenon. There are various reasons why it happens, but we can all help by observing, identifying the warning signs, being there for the person, getting the necessary help for the person, and this way, and also influencing the policymakers, the government, the society as a whole, to take collective steps for the prevention of suicides in the future. So this is the takeaway from today. Number one thing is, it is preventable, and we should remember that.
Right, sir.
And we can all contribute.
Right. I hope all our attendees will do something if they feel that anyone near their circle or family, if they see anyone suffering from such mental state, they can help.
Yeah, every effort counts. Yes.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for
thank you
wonderful session, and thank you everyone for joining on Zoom as well as on Facebook. The recording is available on Facebook, and Zoom will try to share. It's the same thing. And in case any query is unanswered as of now, they can post it on Facebook, sir's page on Facebook.
Right.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you, all of you. God bless you all.
Thank you, sir.